What are you doing, honey?
Carving this pumpkin.
Yeah,
I
you're getting
this
it?
Pumpkin.
Yeah.
Got colors.
That's
up.
Gross. Oh, are you getting it, buddy? Get in there. First time carving a pumpkin. There you go. Get the seeds out. Alright, this is gross, by the way. Just kiss.
I'm gonna pick this one.
Okay, you're gonna try a different spoon too? Alright, that's sick.
Much better.
This isn't much.
Nate hasn't worked on his.
Oh, I'll work on it. Okay, so honey, what are you doing here?
Come check it out.
Come check out what?
Well, you can't test a pumpkin in the daylight, so you gotta make it dark. It's a treasure cat.
Yeah.
All jammed.
Good job.
Yeah.
I walk into the kitchen and I find Kim doing this. And I'm like, what?
We got a double rainbow. Driving home and we got ourselves a double rainbow.
Oh, I didn't even notice the other one.
Yeah, and it goes all the way, actually.
Shouldn't have gotten up there, buddy. I don't know why you're up on the gazebo. You look like you want to get down, though.
Hey, guys. So we're doing a little bit of running around this morning, me and the little guy. And we're picking up straw for Bumper. We got to go pick up some, like, roofing slats. To kind of give the dogs a better area outside of the rain, because the pig and the dogs are fighting over the good dog glue and the good kind of shelter in the backyard, and they're doing this like at 3 o'clock in the morning when it was drizzling the other night. The life of a pet owner, right? But yeah, so that's what we're doing. And then also got to get like the pig food and like some other stuff and go peruse around the hardware store, but yeah, it's the start of Kim's birthday week, so I don't know if anybody else can relate to this or if it's just my wife, but she does a birthday week. Now, she says week leads you to believe it's going to be 7 days, right? It is not 7 days. It is the encompassing 7 days around her birthday, so therefore the 6 days before and the 6 days after. So really it's 13 day holiday week, or birthday week, as she likes to say, which is ridiculous, and I shouldn't put up with it, but I do. Yeah, I don't know. I don't have any real, like, big plans. You know, if stuff goes through and I get things figured out this week with what's going on with me and my career change, then of course it'll be a bit more extravagant. Just due to the fact that kind of little bit of weight and little bit of stress, even though it's not too crazy stressful. It's one of those things where, you know, it's been three, four weeks of looking now, and I've gotten plenty of interviews and I'm going for kind of higher positions and things like that. So I get it, but it's time to figure, get something set in stone. So hopefully that comes through this week. Hopefully today. And then we will go from there, of course. But no crazy plans yet. But we'll keep you guys in the loop. Kind of bring you along, I'm sure, for her birthday. Tonight's Halloween. So we're going to go trick-or-treating with the little guy. We're just running chores and getting stuff done on Monday. But yeah, going to go trick-or-treating tonight at the in-laws. Where we carve pumpkins at. And... yeah, gonna have ourselves a good day. So, anyways, guys, I just thought I'd bring you along for my little venture, and see if it makes the cut. Alrighty, guys, we'll see you later.
Hey, for Bumper.
Yeah, this is where we get the hay for Bumper. Yeah, that's pretty cool stuff, and it's all here. And all this. Did good, buddy. Thank you for helping me. Yeah. And
and yeah, this is where we get it.
That's what we do. We get this for the pig in the winter.
Yes.
And hopefully the dogs can use it as well.
So we're gonna have the top, as you know, for the pig is over here with his big dog Lou underneath, and it just keeps the rain out, and he's warm in there with straw, which we haven't put in yet. And then we made this section over here, and we're gonna put two more of those green like flat things on here. So then we can put the dog glue under there, and this will be like their sleeping arrangements. All this brick is just over the years of like having to come up with different solutions to keep the pig in. Men and their pig.
Good job.
Remember when we bought these earlier?
Yeah.
Dad?
Yes?
I'm just digging.
All right.
Oh, we got almost done.
You want to help me with this?
Huh?
You want to help me with this?
Still about 4 minutes. We'll finish digging.
Watch out for Bumper.
You got over it
off. Hi. Hello. Hello, dirty nose. Hello. Yeah. Look at that dirty nose. Yeah. One of you actually said you wanted to see like a tour of his area for the pig, but this is pretty much it now. When he was younger, he needed more, but now it's pretty simple. And then in his dog glue, he's got a blanket and some dirt he's moved in there.
Oh, a ton of dirt he's moved in there.
Yeah. But then we're gonna just fill this whole thing pretty much with straw. And we use straw, not hay, because hay will get really moldy quickly, and straw does not. And hay's more for feeding, not bedding. We've learned this. But yeah, this will be for the dogs area. But this is pretty much it.
They still have enough room here in the middle.
Yeah.
To do, get out and move around each other and stuff.
Now, I would never put them together like this really before, but over the year, they fight, but not, you know, brutally. And
they fight like friends.
Yeah. And again, our dogs are so tiny that it's not, you know, a big issue.
I think the pig can take them.
Oh, yeah. Oh, piggy. And, but yeah, so this should hopefully work through the winter. These slats are at Lowe's, and they make even longer ones and stuff, too, but we just get these ones. They're long enough. But yeah, it works. Everything's so gross, but it's just that time of year. Oh, Wheelie. Hi. Hi, Wheel. Wheelie gives hugs. Wheelie gives hugs. Yeah. You gonna give hug? You gonna give hug? Oh, Wheelie, thank you. Oh, Wheelie, thank you. Oh, goodness. That's a Wheelie. That's a Wheelie. Yeah. Yeah, she gives hugs. This is my manimals. Okay. Oh, okay. Bring in the...
I have to get it in the tarp or it gets everywhere.
So we bought a big old bale of straw. Yeah, and if we learned our lesson when we did this without tarp, my car still has some.
Okay.
It's crazy. And it's a lot. It's so compacted. And there's really no clean way to do this. Ooh, he smelled that.
You all excited?
Yeah. Oh. Are you excited, Bumper? Is that a present? Happy Halloween. Oh, Bumper. Gotta pop off the ties. And that stuff goes everywhere. But it does work, and it keeps them warm. And if I shove it in...
His side's easy, because he...
He moves it all.
Yeah.
Yeah, he moves it all.
On the side. Back in the corner. Yeah, but he moves it on his own accord.
The neighbor's kid is losing their shit right now.
And I can hide some back there for him.
But put it in the dog glue for the dogs, because they won't put it in there.
I figure Bumper would help him.
Yeah.
He just want to see me get down here and get all dirty in it.
Get all dirty in it.
I don't know if the dogs are going to dig that.
They will. Isn't that right, Kyle? Yeah. Yeah.
Hi, Bruno. Ooh. Hi, Bruno. Hey, Bumper, you want some?
Don't be mean to him.
I'm not being mean to him.
That's not going to end well. That's how a man plays with dogs. We've lost our minds.
What up?
So we're making... These.
The chips again.
The chips again. They're so good. And the dip. It's on my snack video if you have not seen that. Kind of recent. Really good. And if you've never had nutritional yeast, I remember like the first time we had it, we're kind of like, this is weird. I don't know.
You have to cook it because it smells horrible. Yeah. You've got to cook it.
People do sprinkle it on stuff like raw. And I'm sure like we probably would like it a little more now. I don't know about that. And how many tortillas did you do?
Three. And then those are just the ones that don't fit because they'll just burn in the oven because they're too small. But they're good for snacks.
But I mean, it's essentially like three tortillas, a can of beans for the dip, whatever toppings you have to put with that, and you've got yourself a meal.
Yeah.
So I just got back from the store just getting like a few things, and I thought I'd show you guys. I have just been on this kick recently of just literally like... sauteed up some veggies over like plain rice, and I am just so happy with that right now. But I kind of been wanting to like just try a bunch of different kinds of sauces with it, like just very little. So here's what I picked up. I actually got this mandarin teriyaki sauce from like Panda Express, and technically it is vegan. I don't see anything on here that like would lead me to believe it is not. And sometimes you have to just check more so like for honey. And none of these have that. I also got some soy sauce. I really like liquid aminos. But I just told Nate too. I'm like, recently I've been just like wanting regular soy sauce. I'm like, so I'm going to get it. But I did get the like less sodium one. And then this, I have not had this in so long. But we had like this barbecue place here in town that we used to eat at a lot, even when we ate meat and stuff, and they had this katsu sauce and it was really, really good. So I just saw that there and I'm like, yeah, let's get that. And then I also picked up some sweet and sour sauce too. And again, I just really want to have like rice and veggies and eat it and like literally dip my like chopsticks into one of these sauces or multiple. And just for each bite. I don't even want it like drenched on there. I don't know. That's just the kick I'm on. And then tonight, we're actually just gonna do like some romaine lettuce, kind of like a salad, and grill up some veggies though, like the zucchini we bought, some onion, and we have some asparagus. And then gonna do these rice paper wraps. And so I'll like take a picture or something when they're all done. But I've actually never had these before, but it's like where you soak them in like warm water and then you just roll them up like a wrap. So I'm gonna try that out tonight and then dip it into one of these sauces. So yeah, that's what we did. We just went to our local Vons. It's like a Safeway Vons. We go there a lot just for like those few items here and there, but we don't do like primarily our shopping there. It's a little pricey. But yeah, so that's what's going on tonight for dinner. I showed him the ingredients and told him what we were doing earlier. But Nate is making them now. We got two so far. Just bear with us, it's our first time. But we're adding our filling we made and a little bit of the cabbage too we had. some scallions and peppers. It's really weird. It's like a weird texture. It's very sticky.
Mm-hmm.
Sticky. We'll see. Hold on, Bugs.
Oh, no.
Now just scoop it in as you go. There you go.
Hold on, buddy. Oh.
That's close enough. It's fine.
And it just...
It's sticky. But yeah, that's what we're doing. We'll just keep making them until we run out. And you just soak them in here. I poured a couple of those sauces. That's the panda teriyaki one, and that's that katsu one. So we decided tonight we are going to make some nice cream. We have not had like dessert at all in like 2 weeks, which is not a bad thing, but we decided to change it up as we finish the game. So the trick is, because it just takes a little bit of time pulsing it and cut it up pretty small, and obviously you do want them to be frozen. So it will be like very cold. The only con with it that I've been told is that it, once it's done, it does melt fairly quickly. Yeah. So it's one you do kind of want to, you know, make and eat. All right, we'll show you a finished product. So you do want to add just like a little bit, very little, like liquid to it. We're just going to put a little almond milk, and that'll just really like make it bind together. Yum. And I mean, you can add whatever you want to it. You can do like cinnamon in it and whatever you want, but I'm just going to keep it, I think, pretty plain. And then we were thinking about doing strawberries separate and then kind of swirling them together versus blending all together at once. That way you get kind of both flavors. You do basically need a food processor, though, to do this for sure, just because, or blender, because it just, it does take a little bit to get it going. It does help if you do cut up the banana first. So one side of the bowl is going to be mostly banana, and then I'm thinking on this side, a little strawberry, best of both worlds. That just sounded good. It's banana. It's like there's nothing to it, but it just...
But it gets creamy.
It's good, and also with, I think, putting like the vanilla almond milk, the unsweetened vanilla, it just gives it a little bit of something. So put those aside. Oh, guys, we ate those, like, our scraps left, but we tried those, like, spring roll things. So they taste really good. They do. But the consistency of the rice paper, yeah, that's going to have to, like, grow on me. I don't know. It's kind of weird. It's, like, gooey. I will say, I'll link this Ninja below. I love it. It's not a Vitamix. It's not as good as a Vitamix, but for the price, it's a good high-speed blender. And this one comes with, like, the food processor top, and then it also does come with the true full-size, like, blender piece. And this one actually comes with individual serving ones, too.
Yeah.
This one Costco. What you doing back there?
Playing with the camera.
That's right. My camera.
I need to delete the last thing I recorded.
Yeah.
The world doesn't need
Nate
to see
was
that.
Testing it in a Nate fashion. He was testing it.
It was inappropriate.
It was inappropriate.
It was inappropriate.
So it's my birthday, and
I haven't really vlogged in the last couple days, and now I feel like I'm just kind of off from it. And
do we want to tell them the embarrassing fact about what we did?
Okay, listen. So what we did yesterday. Okay, so I don't know what happened. It just happened. So fun fact, we have never seen The Walking Dead. We saw like the first couple episodes of the first season like a long time ago, and we were just like, I don't know, whatever. So then we decided yesterday that we're gonna give it a shot again. Well, something happened, and we watched it from 8 a.m. till midnight.
Baby, we just kept going.
We just stayed in bed like all day, basically. Yeah, I'm not proud, but we did. And we are almost done with season 2 in one day. But
yeah, we did.
It was fun. But look at my new baby.
Yeah.
There she is. Yes.
We'll get both angles. Here, look. I'll hit record.
Oh, wow.
Here. Whoa. We're getting stuff done right now.
Yes, I'm excited. I'm just really excited, too, for, like, with cooking videos. I think it's going to be a lot better quality and shots, and I've been wanting this a while. I decided when I started this, I was going to put my money more so towards the iMac, which is right here. I'm editing the vlog as we speak, and I'm glad I did because I knew I wanted to upload a lot and often, and I just thought that like I need a computer that's going to be able to keep up with the amount of editing. I had a camera, and it's not a bad camera, it's just a little outdated. Because it's actually a camcorder. Everything I film is from a camcorder, except for vlogs is my phone. So it's been good. It's simple to use and everything. Actually, it's right here. It's this little guy right here. And a Sony, what is this? Sony Handycam 4.0 megapixel. 4.0, such a difference. Yeah, wow.
Well, that's
wow. But, I mean, I don't think it was terrible.
No, that was
it really
top
wasn't.
Of the
but yeah, that's
line.
What it is.
7.1. It has GPS in it.
Yeah, it wasn't bad. It just, you know, it was what it was, and this was my next investment in my mind. But it came as a gift, which is fantastic.
Yeah, we got stuff done.
Yeah. But yeah, as far as that goes, we did go to lunch today to Japanese Kitchen. If you're from our area, you know. Aside from that, yeah, just we did lunch and that's about it. Hung out at the parents for a little bit and now back home. It's like 3:30. Gonna edit to get this up for you tomorrow, and then I'm gonna try to learn this camera. I think I already kind of got it though. I get the gist. We'll see. But that's what's going on. But if there's, I know it's not really a fun birthday to like show you a bunch of stuff, but just keeping it low key. But it was a good day. But yeah, say bye.
Bye guys.
But yeah, we'll see. And if not, thanks for watching.